Welcome back to Wasteland 2. Let's go deliver the microscope to Rodia, and hope that they haven't all died of the infection in the time that I've been gone. I'm really hoping that's not on a timer. Please no. You see people belonging to the Robinson group approaching your position. But I'm not enemies with the Robinsons, I just left them alone. Why would they want to fight me? Okay, here we go.
Looking for glamour.
So hopefully by curing this infection, I'll maybe have something happen with the jerks that have taken over the town. But if it has no effect upon that, then I guess maybe I'm just gonna have to kill them. I never actually finished exploring this place, did I? No, I didn't! That's right, I was gonna explore the east side of this place when I was in the crater, and then I got called away somewhere else. So there's more to do in this place than just that. I need to talk to a bunch of people. Let's see, what other quests do I have for this place? I have 3 quests. Yeah, so I need to go find Satan. Need to cure the plague. And I need to help the town in general. Okay. Alright, I don't have to pay the fee to go inside again, do I? Okay, we're good. Doctor!
Matthias is lying to Los Angeles.
Ooh.
He says I will enslave you and will save you.
Whoever's been bringing the mayor food and water...
That's oh my god, 2 people talking at one time, let's make it 3.
You'll be right up there with him. With your mouth
everlasting
shut.
Slavery.
Thanks.
He will never make you his equal. He will never allow you free will. You will be his children. His slaves. Forever. And I don't want to enslave you. I want to destroy you. But at least you will have your freedom. Until your doom comes upon you. Don't let Matthias trick you into eternal torment, Los Angeles. Die free.
God damn it, you freaking leather jerk. You jerk. You dick. You really just had to block that, didn't you? And there's no other door into this place. You fucking... Alright, let me see if reloading will change that. Okay. Jerks. Well, Tom ain't dead yet, so that's a good sign. There's the little girl's body again. This child. I believe that was a little girl, right? Even though it looks like a 20-year-old man. Anyway. You brought it. I never thought you would actually manage it. Now, give me just a second to check these water samples I've collected. Damn it. I was afraid of that. There are parasites in the water from the well in the crater. But how can that be? The farmers have been drinking that water for generations with no ill effects. Something must have changed. Listen, while I figure out how to kill these parasites, please go to the well and see what's tainting it. Maybe a diseased animal fell in. If you find something, take this to fish it out. Dumping disinfectant in the well isn't going to do the job if there's still something rotting down there. I hope it isn't, like, Satan that got stuck in the well. Am I going to have to rescue Satan from the well? Well, I think Satan would be dead. Can you fix this up? Gosh, thanks, Doc. I wanted to see if there's any dialogue options to ask him about the fact that he ran away from the Mannerites, but it looks like there isn't. Okay, into the crater. Now, where's the... I guess it's just here? No, he said it was a well. Where's the well? Oh, there it is. Do-do-do-do-do. Ba-dum-bum-bum-bum-ba-ba-ba-ba-bum-bum-bum-ba-ba-ba-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum Drop the bucket in the well and turn the crank, and pretty soon you'll have some water. Okay. Now afflicted by worm disease effect. I didn't mean to drink it, for fuck. whatever. It only lasts for 500 seconds. Wait a minute. If I can take the worm disease and only last for 500 seconds, then what the hell's wrong with all the locals? Goddamn, y'all have weak stomachs. Anyway, let's use the thingy. What's down there? Hope it ain't Satan, or that guy's gonna be mighty sad. Whoa. A corpse is attached to the end of the hook. Everything in the corpse's pockets is waterlogged, so the notes he was carrying are now illegible pulp. But he did leave a more permanent message. Carved into his chest in deep gashes are the words, "I died for the future." It looks like a dead synth. His artificial arm is rusty, and his body is bloated and pale, except where the worms have burst from his black necrotic belly and hang, slimy and twitching, like the arms of a jellyfish. What in the hell? How can worms live inside of a synth? Alright, well, there's your problem. It's no accident that synth is in there. It's absolutely no accident. Matthias, or whoever's sending these synths, is just trying to sabotage everything. He's trying to kill everyone. Through whatever means necessary. Remember the synth we found back at, whatever the place was called? What the hell was that place called? The place where, like, a synth had broken open some sort of horrible infection? Right, the place where I promised not to tell anybody about the fact that there's a bunch of green mutants just living there? Darwin Village? Yeah, Darwin Village, or whatever it's called. Same thing happened there. You found an evolved in the wall? In the well? Fuck, that's foul. Well, at least you've removed the source. Now we just have to kill all the remaining parasites in the water. Take this disinfectant solution. Throwing that down the well should clear it up. And by the time you get back, I should have the cure prepared. Thank you for the back and forth quest, Doctor. Dr. Time Waster. Why didn't you just give me the disinfectant in the first place, you bag of synth dicks? Well, in the meantime, let's level up.
Copy. Whoa. Ranger Team Echo. Echo, congrats.
That's Theodore. How many skill points? 8? Okay. So, I am really sick of missing speech checks, so... boom. If I keep the trinket on him, I will never miss another one. At least, if it requires kiss-ass. Do I actually want to keep the trinket on him, though? I don't know. The bonus to leadership is mighty good. Mighty good. God, why do I keep doing that? Stop drinking the wormy water. Jesus. Where is it? I didn't see who got it. Oh god, who got it? Who got the thing? What does disinfectant look like? Is it a bottle of bleach? Is that it? That's it. Just looks like a pill bottle. Sweet. Incredible. You succeeded by saving lives, not ending them. Unusual for you. Indeed it is. Don't worry though, we're not done with this town yet. There's plenty of time to murder. Pacify. That's the good PR word, right? We're gonna pacify the region. We're going to neutralize targets. Another euphemism. Did you add the disinfectant to the well? Mm-hmm. Fantastic. All we have to do is wait a day or so and the disinfectant will kill all the parasites. Now, if any of you got sick from the well water, I've got the cure all ready. Just say the word. And I have that cat litter I promised you too. Here you go. Thank you. Yes, actually, I do need the cure. Do I just have to say heal me? I guess? There we go. Okay. Do you have any zeolite? Nope. Okay, I think that finishes that quest, right? We should give him some time to mend the town. Oh, okay. I guess I do actually have to wait. Well, in the meantime, let's go visit the East Said and see if we can find Satan. Searching the east side for Satan. Just another day in the wastes. God, that poor mayor's been there for so many days. Is anybody even feeding him? Loading dock doors are locked, and the main door is guarded by a leather jerk. I think it's talking about that there. What's going on here? Is this like a warehouse district here? And, did I ever actually go inside of the bank? Whatever this is, I don't think I'm supposed to be here. Oh no, this is behind here. This is the front entrance that's guarded. Yeah, no, I'm not supposed to be there. Ooh, there's a bunch of possums there. Maybe Satan's in with the rest of them. Satan? By Limbo Town standards, this is a mansion. It's made of sturdy stone and wood. It doesn't lean or sag, and it has a fresh coat of paint. It's also twice as big as its neighbors. Whoever lives there must be doing pretty well. Is he talking about this? Oh yeah, look at this place. Look at that floor wood paneling. Beautiful. And look at the... Oh! It's a possum and little baby possums. Hold on, though. Let me look over these. Any of these, Satan? They all look the same. Nope. Easy, old girl. What the hell, Dante? That was our best rug. I'll get another rug. Old Lemmy's life was at stake. She nearly didn't... Life? Life? I have a life. That's a fucking possum in our fucking house. Come on, Beatrice. You knew I was a farmer when you married me, and a farmer has to run the farm. I knew you were a rich farmer. You have people to do this shit. Beatrice, please, I... Save it for the possums, limp dick. Ah, see? They look like you. Maybe you and Virgil can raise them together. I'm out of here. Beatrice, come back! Or Beatrice, I don't know, whatever. What's going on with this here bosom? That wouldn't happen to be Satan, would it? A lean-jawed, wind-etched older man in a cowboy hat and work clothes. He is covered in the dirt of honest work. What can I do for you? Dante Goodman's my name. The lady who left is my wife, Beatrice. She, well, I suppose she had a right to be mad. But farm ways die hard in an old farmer. Looks like farming has paid off for you. It is my life's work. And it is been good to me. Though I'm not liking it so much now. Shouldn't have made that deal with the leather jerks. Oh god, what deal did you make? Why the mayor ever thought hiring such men was a good idea, I'll never know. Bunch of thieving hoodlums. And that dangler's the worst of the lot. The deal I made with him is the dumbest thing I ever done. Wish somebody'd do something about him.
Be quiet. There's one behind you. I think he's reading your books. Shh.
I'm sorry, what were you saying about how awesome leather jerks are? They're wonderful. They're not jerks at all.
Okay, he's gone.
Tell me more about Dangler. Shook his hand once, made sure I had all my fingers when I was done. Should have done the same thing when I introduced him to my wife. Wait, what happened between Dangler and your wife? That's what I'd like to know. She's with him more than she's with me these days. Says she's negotiating a better deal, but for who? What do you think of the mayor? Everybody seems to hate him. Thought he's a bad mayor. And, yep. So what was your deal with Dangler? They offered me a fortune to stop growing anything but agaves so they could turn it into liquor. Some deal they offered all the farmers. I didn't want to do it, but Beatrice said it would make us rich. I wanted to make her happy, so... Well, now I'm regretting it. With everybody growing booze makings for the jerks, nobody's growing anything to eat. People are starving, getting sick, and none of us have seen any money either. Dangler tells us it's all deposited in our accounts at the bank, but nobody can get any money out of there, just bullets, and damn few of them. Sickness? I already know about the sickness. Yep. Tell me about the bank. That no good gecko started kissling Dangler's behind the minute he came to town. I think they're in cahoots. Aiming to milk Rodia like a possum, I swear. Milk Rodia like a possum? Can you milk possums? Is that a thing? Your wife is, very expressive. Oh, she's just a little high-strung sometimes, but I love her anyway. If you see her, tell her to come home. I guess I probably should have started with this, but your name is Dante? They say I'm named after a guy who went through hell to get the woman he loved. Maybe I did it backwards. Well, since your name is Dante, I don't suppose you would know Satan? So, you breed possums? Yep. I'm told that before the war they were much smaller and considered pests. Now they're our best livestock. We raise them for the milk and the meat. Tasty any way you slice them, that's for sure. Sure, I especially love the fact that they all seem to have horrible, like, radiation-burned scabs. Looks delicious. Do you have any cat litter? Holy crap, he just gave me a bag of cat litter. Cat litter? You have cats? Great little creatures, aren't they? Catch mice and rats, and they're cute, too. Well, because you helped Dr. Horchata and the town looks like it's on the mend, here's the cat litter you asked for. I hope it makes your cats happy. Take care.
I don't have any cats, but thank you.
Now, you lazy son of a bitch, why don't you do something? Help this town! If I had done anything, you mean risking my life or the lives of other farmers, well, I ain't had the courage. Too many people been hurt already. But maybe I got something lying around that might help you do what you do best. I tell you what, you get my wife away from these jerks and out of danger. I'll give it to you. I call it The Haman Hot Potato. Huh? It's a magnesium infused shaped charge left over from when we enlarged the crater, named after its late inventor. Thing'll blow through buildings, rock, solid steel, anything. You could blast into the tower's stronghold with it. Hell, you could melt through the walls of Gecko's safe if you wanted to. You get Beatrice to safety, and it's yours. Okay, and where could we put your wife to put her out of danger? Tell you what, I've got a tool shed on my farm. You tell Beatrice I'm finally going to show her where all my fortune's hid and bring her there. I'll keep her put up and give you the hot potato. Then you can do what you want with the leather jerks and she'll be safe and sound. I think I kind of already picked the lock for your little shed there and kind of stole the stuff inside of it. This possum has just given birth. Her newly born pups cling blindly to her underbelly and mewl piteously. Isn't nature beautiful? Aw, I can't whistle to it. Ah, where is Satan? Maybe it is one of these things. I don't know. Hold on, where's the, snack? Because I have Satan's snacks somewhere. Possum snacks. No, I don't just want to use that on any possum, because then I just waste it. Gotta find Satan first. Wait, what the hell? Help, help, my daughter's boyfriend is beating her up and I can't stop. What the fuck? What's going on? Can I help you? I guess I'm just gonna follow her. I can't talk to her. Where are you going? Where the hell do you live? You can't live back here, can you? Where are you going? Huh? This is how you're getting to your daughter that you're trying to help? What? Those are some weird poses there. You know what? I think that might be Beatrice. And, what happened? Oh, okay, she's going the other way. Alright. I think she forgot how to get home. Am I not intended to help? Maybe I'm just not intended to help. She seems confused. I think I'm gonna stop following her, because I don't think she actually knows where she's going. Okay, bye. So, they probably wouldn't like it if I just went in through the front entrance, would they? I mean, is it locked? Oh, it is. There's some big stuff in here. Big machinery, bunch of people. I want to get inside. Graphic novel. This comic book isn't very funny. Okay, so I need to get to Beatrice, get her into safety, get the object, the hot potato or whatever the hell it's called. I don't know what the hell I want to do with that, though. This is the finest house in Rodia. Strong, sound, and well-maintained. In fact, there's some maintenance going on right now. Along the side of the house, you see a bunch of paint cans and scaffolding. At the front, there's a little patch of lawn, with a statue in the middle and a picket fence around it. It also has two leather jerks guarding the front door. Wait, a little patch of lawn with a statue in the middle and a picket fence around it. Huh? I don't see the lawn or the statue. What are you talking about? I see a fire inside of some, like, cinder block dividers. What are you smoking, game? They said there's some scaffolding on the side, so, maybe I could walk up there and sneak inside. But, first, let's just try the front entrance. This is the boss's house. What do you want here? Oh, this is where the boss is. Then I wonder what the other place is. I heard there's work available. Alright, go on in. But talk to Lieutenant Dangler. Boss O'Biggin is much too busy to talk to the likes of you. I don't think I could ask about them. Just don't even try. Dangler, yep, okay. Alright, is Beatrice in here? As you enter the house, you see a bent old woman cleaning the hall. She gives you a cool once-over, then glances into a side room and steps to you. The interior is as staid and stolid as the exterior. At least, it was. Now empty bottles, possum bones, and dirty clothes are strewn across the tasteful carpets, and someone's punched holes in many of the paintings. A drunk leather jerk snores on a couch. More play cards at a table in the main room. Others stare at a TV with a broken screen. There's O'Biggin. I want to see if I can slip some of that tainted meat into his diet. A bent old woman cleaning the hall. You ain't no jerks. Don't look dumb enough. What you here for, then? Kess level 5, that is easy. We're here to help Rodia. Glad to hear you say it. I miss the mayor ever so much. If you was to get rid of these rascals and bring them back safe, I'd... Well, I ain't got much. I might be able to point y'all to something nice. And I just might be able to help y'all out, too. How can you help? Well now, if you peek around through the door over there, you'll see all of Dangy's boys hanging out in the parlor, putting their feet on the furniture, and throwing chicken bones in the fireplace. But being as I'm the housekeeper, I got the keys to that door. I could lock them in. They wouldn't be able to come running if old Dingy was to maybe call for help for some reason, you see? I can't say them boys will stay locked up for long, so you best be ready to do something old Dangy before I lock the door. Just give me a sign when you are. Okay. You don't think much of the leather jerks? She kind of already answered that, but let's see. Nope. Alright. Okay, good to know. Well, let's not do anything too rash at the moment. We still need to talk to a Dangler. We still have the tainted possum meat. We still need to find Beatrice. Wait, where is Dangler? Hello? Okay, maybe we do have to go in here. Oh, there we go. Hello! God damn, O'Biggin is big. And Beatrice is not here. Where did she go? Okay. What am I gonna say? I have no freaking clue. Ah, the strangers I've been hearing so much about. Oh god. O'Biggin wants to eat us. Well, I have something you can eat. But if I just hand him a bunch of tainted possum meat, he eats it and then dies in front of me, they're probably gonna know who did it. I just realized, I just sent Theodore to go talk to this guy, and Theodore isn't even wearing any pants. I'm doing a tense negotiation in my underwear. Cross a punk rocker and a leprechaun, this is what you would get. You look smarter than your average jerk, and more ambitious than the town folks of Rodia. The townsfolk of Rodia. Those are qualities I could use. Unless, of course, you think what we're doing here is wrong. Oh no, of course not. No, you're wonderful people. I love jerks. I think I'm just gonna dodge those questions completely. Dante wants Beatrice back at home. I don't know if I want to ask him that. No, let's not do that. You have any cat litter? Cat litter? Ah, of course, you're impatient to get to Hollywood before the winter winds clear the radiation belt. Well, how you spend your free time is your concern, but we have no cat litter. You're welcome to what you find in town, but I don't know of any. Perhaps the ugly doctor. What do you think about Dante? The richest and most influential of the farmers that work the crater, and a stubborn man. But I'm working on him. He'll come around in the end. What do you think about the crater? Do you know that before we took over, 90% of the farmland in that crater was devoted to fruits, vegetables, and grazing land for bossums? What a waste. Now 99% is devoted to agave plants, all of which goes directly to the distillery to be turned into booze, and from there into money in the bank. So much untapped potential in those fields. What were those farmers thinking? What are you thinking, you fucking idiot? God damn, you can't live on agave. That must be what that big machine I saw and that other thing was. That must be the distillery. Interesting. I really don't know what I want to do at this point. I mean, I have the tainted possum meat, so I could kill O'Biggin in some way. If I can get Beatrice to safety, I can get a thing that will allow me to do something. You know, I think he mentioned that maybe I could, like, bust open the bank. Using the potato thing. And since everybody's ammo is inside of the bank, maybe I could bust it open and, like, arm all of the townsfolk. And they can have a revolution, because that's what's stopping them from having a revolution, or whatever you want to call it, right? That's what's stopping the townsfolk from fighting back, is the fact that they can't get their ammunition, at least not in large amounts. Not in large enough amounts to really do anything. What do you think about the townsfolk? They're the sheep and we are the wolves. It's the natural order of things, of course. Do I really want to say this? I guess. Let's see what happens. Dante wants Beatrice back at home. I don't think this is something I want to be saying to him, but let's see. Dante asked you to bring her home? Why don't you ask her if she wants to go? She's a grown woman. She can make up her own mind. Okay, but where is she? I have no idea. I wonder if I have a high enough speech, if I could convince him that what he's doing is wrong. But if I can convince him, he's probably gonna kill me. Or try to. I could try kissing his ass for now, but let's not do that. What do you think about Rodia? This town was as open as a hooker's legs before we saved it from the sins. All were welcome. Nobody was turned away. No tariffs to get in. All the policies of that ridiculously idealistic mayor, who believed that sharing Rodia's wondrous bounty could bring civilization back to Los Angeles. Absurd. Making people pay through the nose for Rodia's wondrous bounty will bring civilization back to Los Angeles. That's how the world works. So what's the deal with the synths? No idea what their deal is, but I'm glad they were giving Rodia a hard time. It gave us the opportunity we were looking for. What about the mayor? If you don't know enough to get out of the way of progress, progress will run you over. Or, perhaps, hang you from a tower for everyone to see what happens when you impede progress. Now he can see the casino I made of his tavern. The distillery I made of his backyard still. The money-making machine I made out of his bank. Tell me about the tower. Beauty of the towers, uh-huh. Tell me about the casino. 100% profit. It's not so much a casino as a green-felt abattoir. And for those who like a different sort of game, there are hookers in the back. Have I been to the casino? I can't remember. And what about the bank? The intricacies of high finance are no doubt beyond you, but I'm very pleased with what we've done with the bank. Mr. Gecko has been a helpful and judicious partner in this enterprise. And the distillery? The opportunity with the most potential in this dreary little town, and its owner, the mayor, and his lazy son, did nothing with it. I don't think they produce 20 barrels of booze in a year. I'm working on producing 20 barrels in a week. We'll be rich. Of course it would be easier if I didn't have to deal with either of them. What about the hookers? Another profitable scheme. The townsfolk spend both bullets and seed on my harlots, leaving them weaker in spirit as well as defense. Okay, I'm getting out of here. Thanks for dropping in. Bye now. There's Beatrice. It looks like Beatrice is here to stay. She's over in the corner checking herself out in the mirror. Oh my god. You're so vain. Dang, you don't like me talking to strangers. Okay. So I can't convince her? Oh my god, oh, Biggin is so stupid. And the guy at the door did tell me that I shouldn't even try talking to O'Biggin, so I guess I won't. I don't know, he might shoot me just for trying to talk to him. Okay. I need to visit, like, the bank or something, right? I mean, I feel like I haven't visited the bank or the casino. Maybe I have, but I don't know.
Okay, listen. I know everybody's worried about the sickness that's going around, but please, please, don't call it a plague. It's bad for morale. Thanks.
Well, you'll be happy to know I already solved it. No, I actually haven't been in here. Okay. I'm sorry, did you want something? This guy has guns hanging off all over him. Surely he wouldn't miss one or two. Need some bullets to get back in the game. He's drunk. Let's trick the jerk and give him some rocks, because he seems dumb. He seems rock stupid. But wait, I don't actually have any rocks. Alright, whatever. I don't really use these. Sure, have some. Wait, what? What, does it have to be a rock now that I said I'm gonna give him a rock? But I don't have any rocks. What? You want a dildo? Oh, fuck off. Here, have some bullets. Sure. Here. You can have 10. Shanks. What's in here? Someone just threw away a gun. Okay, fresh meat. Yeah. Behind the bar, and beneath a mop of graying hair, the round face of a born bartender smiles at you, then looks uneasily at the leather jerks. Here to drink? Or do you want some of that nastiness those leather jerks are selling in my back room? Well, actually, I came for cat litter. Ah, you're looking for rat suit makings, right? Well, I haven't got any. But some of the farmers keep cats. Ask old Dante. Mm-hmm, okay. What kind of nastiness are they selling? They got games of chance I got no chance in them, and horrors that are even a worse bet. And the jerks tell me they're helping me bring in customers by providing entertainment. Nobody wants what these thugs are selling. Tell me about the horrors. Call me old-fashioned, but I like a lady who has the same number of legs and nipples as I have. Those strumpets got too many of everything for my taste. Oh right, those are the people that have like four legs and stuff, right? Is it worth trying the games in the casino? I wouldn't. Those jerks cheat. What do you think about the jerks? Yep, yep, yep. Oh my god. Obigan already know, Dangler already know. Just in case these open up new things, I'm just gonna click on them, but I kind of already know what they say. The big fella is Pat the Axe. A mean old bastard, not much for talking, but he sure likes to drink. I'm not quite sure who he's talking about, I'm assuming it's somebody in the bar. What's with all the bullets? How do you feel about the mayor? He's a dick. Poor old Sam, an idiot rich boy. Yep, yep, yep. So it sounds like Gecko, who runs the bank, is a bit of a piece of shit. Oh my god, there's so many dialogue options. Most of these I just don't need. Agave. There's a sickness going around? No shit, I already solved it. Hmm. Oh, okay. Yeah, so it looks like I can, like, set a bunch of things in motion. Like, nobody wants to do anything directly, or anything too extreme for the most part, but they're all willing to help me in some way, like this guy. Like, he's no good in a fight, but I could maybe slip old Pat the Axe here a Mickey if you wanted me to. Could take him out of the game. Who's Mickey? A Mickey Finn. A time-honored practice among dishonorable bartenders. Sadly, I ain't got no makings. But if you're gonna start something with the jerks, and you wanted to even the odds a bit, you could give me some chloral hydrate from the clinic. A little of that in Pat's tequila and he wouldn't wake up till it was all over. Hmm. What's with all the leather? It's like a fetish with them. I hear their favorite leather is made from the people they kill. Hope they don't make a pair of sandals out of poor old mayor. Give us a drink. We've got tequila or tequila, but only if you can pay. So just tequila? Not much of a selection. It's gotta be because of the agave. Yep. Tequila. No thanks. I'm good. Well, let's slip on over here and go get some drugs to prep the bartender to help me out if I need it. Can't hurt. Given how much I've helped the doctor, hopefully he'll be cool with me taking some drugs. Excuse me. I'll work at the bar, said you might have some chloral hydrate. He needs, help with some household pests. Wink. By which you mean he needs it to take out the leather jerks. An admirable plan. Thank you. Damn, he saw through my ruse. Now if you just give this drink to old Pat over there, he won't make it to the party. He's had a few drinks already today, so you might have to wake him up first. Okay, well, I guess I probably shouldn't do that just yet, should I? No. What does the quest say? I guess it didn't update? Not sure. Is that a toaster? There's a toaster in the bar. Hanging on a peg behind the bar is a curious gun with intricate details carved into the barrels. A plaque next to it reads, Hoblet's Problem Solver. That's gotta be a reference to something. Ah, there's old Pat the Axe. Just leave him there for now. Alright, what's going on in the back rooms? Uh-oh. We got a gambler here. Come on. Come on. Oh! Yeah, I don't like those odds. What the hell? He had a keyboard in his pocket? Okay, I'll take it. Ah, a risk taker. Pick a caliber, friend. No thanks. Oh god, what's gonna happen to this person? Oh, nothing apparently. A serious-looking man in a surprisingly well-preserved tuxedo sits at a table with a red square and a black square painted on it. He shuffles a deck of cards and looks you in the eye as you pass. Look, I'm pretty sure that's not a tuxedo, but okay. The rules are simple. You put a bullet on red or black, then I turn over a card. If the color matches the color you picked, you win. Otherwise, you lose. Got it? Then place your bet. Okay. Red. A fine choice. Place your bet. Let's use crappy ammo. Sorry, it's a white card. You lose. There was a white card. That's right. All the cards are white. Wait, what? Okay. Red. I know he's cheating. Let's just see where this goes. Sorry, it's a white card. You lose. Black? Thankfully, I don't care about this ammo at all. Oh, it's a white card. You lose. What a surprise. You said there was a winner every time. I don't actually know if he said that, but sure, let's say it. There is. Me. Oh. True. I don't know if I want to call him out on cheating. Let's not, because then I might, like, make all of the thugs try to kill me. You okay over there? This peculiar machine accepts scrap and pays out in bullets. The cost is 10 scrap per game. Sure. Balls. I'll get rich one of these days. Oh, just one more. Just one more. Nah, whatever. What's going on back here? Ah, yes. Prostitute, why is there a goat? Why is there a goat? Fun bags galore. Yeah, what did he say? Like, people with, like, five legs and, like, a bunch of nipples? I don't even know. I'm probably gonna get an STD if I sleep with any of them. Numerous valleys. Looking for a little magic? 20 bullets and I'll take care of you like you've never been taken before. No thanks. I'm good. I want to see somebody with, like, 10 legs. I thought you had, like, 10 legs or something. Man, I'm disappointed. Johnny Two Fingers? You have more than two fingers. Oh my god, your image there looks way different than your model looks. I'm scared of him. No thanks. I'm gonna get, like, 20 kinds of STDs. Alright, the only other place that I feel like I haven't visited is the bank. Where is the bank? Where's this gecko? Where the hell is the bank? So this is the casino, that's the hospital. This is like the distillery, that's the main house. Well, this is where the tower is. Maybe the bank is inside of the tower? Wait, what's this? Could this be it? No, I don't think that's it. Hold on. I'm gonna go try to find the bank and I'll be right back. Oh, yeah, this is actually the bank. Yeah, it is. A prim woman in an often patched pantsuit. She looks more proper than helpful. Would you like to make a deposit? A withdrawal? Exchange currency? Actually, I'd like to speak to Gecko. Make a withdrawal, even though I don't think I have any money. Certainly, what's your account number? I don't have an account. Ah, then you'll want to talk to our president, Mr. Gecko. He opens all new accounts personally. Shall I call him for you? Of course. Hello! I heard you were a piece of shit. I'm just gonna close these doors behind us. I'm Morton Gecko. Welcome to the Bank of Cordite. I understand you well-armed folks would like to open an account and secure your ammo. Secure my ammo. Uh-huh. Are you sure you're secure? We just saw a robbery. Oh, that was a while ago, wasn't it? I think that was a long time ago, but, sure, let's say that. Oh, that. Hardly a robbery. A desperate man grabbed a handful of loose bullets from the teller and made a run for it. The leather jerk stopped him. A sad, yet effective, demonstration of our security. So you approve of the leather jerks? I do. The, outgoing mayor brought them in as security consultants when the synths showed up. But, okay, yeah, I pretty much already know that stuff. Doesn't like the... Yep, it's got a radio and the towers and the synths. Do you have any cat litter? Now why would a bank have cat litter? Such a silly question. Yeah, well... shut up. Tell me about the bank. A trusted institution that's helping Rodia to get back on its feet. We have the strongest safe in the LA wetlands. Is your safe safe? Indeed it is. In addition to the guards, the rope you see... the rope you see means that I or tellers can close and lock the safe anytime we feel alarmed. And the time lock mechanism renders it unopenable for 12 hours. This gives everyone in the town time to mobilize and defend their ammunition. I assure you, your ammunition is safe with us. I'd like to open an account. Excellent. I'll write down your details and inform our teller. When you're ready, just deposit currency of any kind with her and you're all set. I do want to remind you, however, that we only pay out withdrawals in bullets, which are the only legal tender in Rodia. Use bullets as money, yep. Okay. I thought that might lead to something interesting, but it didn't. What is down there? And that's the vault. So, I could break open the vault even if it gets completely shut. If I had the bomb thing that the guy wants to give me if I help get Beatrice to safety. Okay, well, I think we're right about at the point where I need to kind of make a move. I have the tainted meat. I have the poisoned booze. There's quite a few things I can do, but I need to start doing something. And if that means simply opening fire on everyone, then maybe that's what it's gonna have to be. Maybe. There's probably a better option, though. I really like the idea of, like, opening up the vault and giving, like, getting everybody's ammo from the vault and just, like, having an uprising. I don't know if I can do that, though. We'll see, though. I think I'm gonna save that for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.